LTSpice is powerful electronic circuit simulator software and it is free. Probably because it is free, not too much effort has been put in its user interface. Even though it is perfectly capable of what it is designed for, it does not look pretty and it lacks user friendliness. But with a bit of effort, it can be a valuable tool, which is why in this video I will show you how to get started with LTSpice. In the summer 2020 edition of Elector magazine, on page 65, we published a small circuit capable of blinking an LED for 2 years while powered from a 1.5 alkaline AA battery. The circuit uses only 3 transistors, yet it is an oscillator and a boost converter. The oscillator allows blinking the LED, while the boost converter makes sure that the LED lights up, because 1.5 volts is not enough to light an LED. A basic red LED needs 1.8 volts or so, and a blue or white LED even more than 3 volts. The circuit as published has a third interesting feature. It doesn't work with the given component values. All these features make the circuit a good candidate for analysis with LTSpice. First, download LTSpice from the Analog Devices website and install it. Note that there is no Linux version. I assume that you know how to download a file and how to install it. Open LTSpice and click New Schematic, the button in the top left. Now the toolbar here becomes active, and so we can have a look at it. Here we have draw a wire, place a ground symbol, place a label, place a resistor, place a capacitor, place an inductor, place a diode, place a component, move something, drag something, this is undo and redo, rotate and mirror. You can add text to a schematic and you can add SPICE directives. To analyze the LED blinker circuit in LTSpice, we must first draw it. Now we start by placing the resistors. Click the resistor button and place one here. To zoom, you use the scroll wheel on the mouse. So R1 is about here, then we place R2 here. R3, we must rotate it. You can do that with Control R. Goes about here, then R4, rotate it again, rotate R4 3 times to make it look the same as R1, place it about here, R5 goes here, R6 comes here, and finally R7 goes at the same height as R2, which is about here. Press Escape to end placing resistors. Next, we place a capacitor. Click the Place Capacitor button, and the capacitor goes in series with R4, so we place it here. Escape to end. For C2, we need a polarized capacitor, and we get that from the Components button, so we click the Component button. Here we have non-polarized capacitors, and the polarized are called Polcap. Take one. We have to rotate it. One time is enough, and then it goes about here. Escape ends the operation. Next we will place in the transistors. Transistors are also on the component menu. We want NPN. There are several types. The only difference is the bar, as you can see, except for NPN4, which has an extra connection. So we take NPN1, Q1 or T1 in our schematic goes here somewhere, Q2, T2 is below R5 here, and key Q3 goes up here, must be mirrored, Control E is to mirror, Control R to rotate, and then we place it about here. And now we need an LED, again from the component menu, LED, and we place that one here. And finally, we need a battery. That's a voltage source. We can get one from here, voltage, again, and replace that here. And the next step is to wire the circuit. So now that we have placed all the components, we can wire them up. For that, we can click either the wire button, or we can use hotkey F3. To start a wire, you click a connection, a pin. So from here to here, for instance. And from here to here, here's another one. As you can see, a junction is created automatically. If you make a mistake, you can correct it with the scissors, the cut icon. You can also use it to draw a block, and then it will delete everything inside the block. I press escape when done. You saw that when I did this, the schematic moved. You can move the schematic by clicking somewhere on the background, zoom with the mouse wheel, and move the sheet by holding down the left mouse button while moving the mouse. Okay, we continue our wiring. Okay, so now, for instance, this wire is a bit too close to transistor Q3. We can drag it with the drag icon. We can move it, drag it. You can also move it, but when you move it, you just move the wire segment. You can also move a component. To undo an action, you can use the undo button, or you can press F9. You can redo it with the redo button or shift F9. So now we have wired the whole circuit. The next step is to add the values to the components. To set the value of a component, you do a right click with the right mouse button on a component to open up its properties window. The value of R1 is 1 mega ohm. In LTSpice, the M, the letter M, capital or not, is reserved for milli. So to make it a mega ohm, you have to type meg. And we give it a tolerance of 5%. The power rating, we leave it as is. For R2, we do the same thing. So a right click on R2, we type 1 meg. And we set a tolerance of 5%. You can also do 1000K. It's the same as 1 meg, of course. R4, 10K. Okay, now we have R5, R6 and R7 are also 10K resistors. So instead of having to open the window all the time, we can simply copy R4. So first we delete R5, 6 and 7. Then we copy R4. For that we use the copy function. You can do it from the edit duplicate. It's called duplicate, or you do F6. So F6. With F6 you can do a block or just one part. We do one part, so we click on R4 and replace R5. Then we place R6 and we copy R6 to create R7. So that saves us some typing. When done with copying, we do escape. Next, we can set the value of this capacitor. This is 100 nano, so this is an N. And we don't have to set up all these values. If you want to do a real good simulation, you can select a capacitor from the capacitor that it knows of. So these are all 100 nanos. For C2, we have to specify 100 micros. So that's the U from micro. Again, we can select one from the list. It has a rating of 6 volts according to the schematic. So we pick a 100 micro 6 volt type here. An aluminium, we want an aluminium. There we go. Well, let's do the transistor now. Here, the same thing. Right click on the transistor. But here you have to do pick new transistor to select it from a list. We want the BC548. Now this is not ordered. So if you want to order it, you click on the header. Part number, now it's ordered. In the part number column, we scroll down and we see that we have the BC547, but not the 548. We do have the BC848, which is the SMD version of the 548. So we pick this one. Now the LED, this is a special case. And we have to pick a new diode. Here you have to select the type column to sort the type, and then you can find the LEDs. They're in there, there they were. Here they are. For some reason, there is no normal red LED in LTSpice. This one is a white LED with a forward voltage of more than 3 volts. It's not exactly what we want, but let's use it for now. Okay, finally, we have to set the voltage. Right click on the voltage and then you can type 1.5 volts. And now it's interesting to click the advanced button, where you can see that you can make this voltage source much more complicated than what it is now. Now it's just a DC voltage, but you can make it a pulse, a sine, an exponential, a piecewise linear, and you can even edit, give it a file. So this window gives you lots of options. We don't need this now, so we just do this one. We can set a series resistance, but we leave that open for now. Okay, so now our schematic is ready and we can simulate it. Before simulating the circuit, we save the file, of course, so we click the save button here, or you do the save button there. To simulate, we use the simulate button, run. And now we must define the simulation. Now this is a very simple time domain simulation, so we let it run for say 10 seconds. The stop time is 10 seconds. And we don't have to set anything else because we are not going to do anything more difficult. And you can go much further here, of course, and you will if you want to do something serious. So you have AC analysis, DC sweep, noise, DC transfer, and a DC operating point. We will do a transient simulation over a duration of 10 seconds. We click OK. Now you must select the signals you want to visualize by clicking in the circuit. As you can see, if you hover over the wires, the cursor changes into a probe. There are two types of probes, a current probe, which looks like a current clamp, and a voltage probe, which looks like a multimeter probe. Now we are, of course, interested in the LED signal, so we click this signal here. And we click, let's say, also this signal here, which corresponds to the signals 1 and 2 in the schematic. And to our surprise, we see that nothing is happening. Now, how can that be? Well, the first thing to check, of course, is to see if the schematic is correct. As I said, there was a problem with the component value. And if you paid attention when I drew the circuit, then you already know where the problem is. It is of course a Q3, which is an NPN transistor in our circuit, but it is drawn as a PNP transistor in the article, even though it is listed as an NPN transistor. So we are going to replace this transistor by a PNP type and see if things improve. So we remove this one, we get a new one, we take the PNP here. Control E, Control RR twice. So now the transistor type is correct. You have to set its value. All right. Now let's save the schematic and run the simulation again. Ah, so now we have signals, but they do not look like the signals printed in the article. So something appears to be wrong. Well, actually there is a mistake in our schematic. It is not really a mistake, but something that we forgot to add to the schematic, and that is a ground reference. In LTSpice, every circuit must have a ground reference. You can add one by clicking the ground button and then connect the ground symbol to a net. It doesn't really matter which net you call ground, as long as you have one. So let's place it here on the same net as in the original circuit. So we save the schematic and now run the simulation again. Okay, and now we have signals that look like the ones shown in the article. On the y-axis we have voltage, and on the horizontal or x-axis is the time. In the lower left corner you can see the xy position of the mouse. However, it is easier to use cursors, which you add by clicking on the name of a signal. With the mouse you can pick up the cursor and move it around. When you click another signal's name, the cursor will attach to that signal. It is also possible to have two cursors on one signal. For this you right click on the signal's name and then select the first and second cursor here, and then click OK. The two cursors are at the same position, so you pick one up and drag it somewhere, and then you move the other. The positions and the difference between the two cursors are shown in this window, allowing you to measure durations and frequencies. Now when you start clicking around in the schematic to look at signals, you will quickly lose track of what is what. This is why it's a good idea to add labels to the circuit. You can do this with the label net button or by pressing F4. Entering a name is enough, just place it where you want it, like the labels 1 and 2 in the original drawing. Mathematical operations on signals can be done easily. Just right-click on the signal's name and enter an algebraic expression in the large box. For instance, subtract signal 1 from signal 2, like this. Our simulation is working, but we do not have the right LED. The LED we used is a white one, and to change it into a red LED requires adding a model to the schematic. It is easy to find one on the internet. To use it, the easiest way is to simply paste it into the schematic, like this. To connect it to the component, you must change the value of the part. This is not the same thing as a right-click on the part to open its properties, but instead a right-click on the value field. Here you enter the name of the model. Now when you run the simulation, it will use the new model. The signals 1 and 2 now resemble even more the signals shown in the article. So now let's estimate the current consumption of the oscillator. We run the simulation and then instead of measuring voltages, we will measure current. To do so, you must hover the mouse over a component, like so. Except for a transistor, then you must hover over one of its pins. We will measure battery current, so hover the mouse over the voltage source until the cursor changes into a current clamp. Click on it to show the current trace. If you click again, then the other traces will disappear. You will notice that the current is negative. This is because LTSPICE assumes the current to flow from the positive to the negative terminal of a voltage source, whereas the electrons go the opposite way. We can fix this by adding a minus sign in front of the graph, like this. So getting the average current consumption of the circuit is actually super easy, once you know the trick. And the trick is a control left click on the name of the graph. So in my simulation this is 106.6 microamps, which is pretty close to the 100 microamps given in the article. So we will stop here for now. In this video I have shown you how to draw a circuit in LTSPICE and how to get a simulation going. We looked at edit options and how to avoid the common pitfalls. Now we even imported a simple model that we downloaded from the internet. Yet we have only scratched the surface of LTSPICE. It has many, many more options that are more or less hidden or obscure. Therefore, do not hesitate to right-click on objects, no matter what, from components to graph scales. Also, take some time to go through the menus, as it really is an incredibly powerful tool. Okay, that's it. I hope you found it interesting. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click or tap the bell button. Thank you for watching.